The excuses we got.
Oh, yes, I would. I warned you.
Yes, I know, Mrs. Reynolds, but there was no sense to what they had to say. As soon as they heard the word prisoners, that was it. No discussion, finish, end of conversation.
And Marty was wonderful too. Made the deal sound really attractive.
Well, you've still got plenty of time. Unless you think it's hopeless, of course.
Oh, no, we're not giving up.
Well, no, we'll be at it again tomorrow.
Good. Well, there's more to life than work experience. Aren't you two supposed to be on duty?
I know what they're going through. I had the same trouble when I was in family welfare.
Well, I'm not worried. With Bulldog Jackson on the job, they'll get something. I mean, they may end up in the Army or the Navy, but they'll get something.
Well, that reminds me, Bob Moran called.
Oh, how is he?
Fine. In fact, we might see him today. He's coming down to be a character witness for Kath Maxwell.
Poor Bob. Do you think if she gets off, they'll get together?
It's a very big if. First of all, she has to convince the court that she's sorry for killing her little girl. And she isn't Meg. She killed that child because she loved her.
Would you mind waiting outside while I talk to Mrs. Maxwell?
Oh, no, no, of course not.
Thank you. You were wonderful, Mrs. Maxwell. I watched you walk through that crowd and you were perfect.
It was a lie.
It's what they wanted to see.
So that's what it's come down to, has it? It makes them feel good if I shed the occasional tear. Well, I don't think I can keep it up.
You'll have to.
When I saw those sanctimonious faces, I wanted to scream. I wanted them to know why I killed Linda.
They know why. Now they want you to be sorry for it.
I'm not. The child was suffering.
And unless they see you suffering, unless the crowd, the press and the court see you suffering, you'll spend the rest of your life in Wentworth. The plea has been changed to manslaughter. Now, that took a lot of hard work and bargaining, so please, please, don't let yourself down now.
What about my character witnesses?
Bob Moran will be here on time.
And my husband?
Mrs. Maxwell, everything is all right. Trust me. I know my job.
Perhaps we could get her to attack someone.
Who?
Oh, I don't know. Someone she isn't very fond of.
Well, it'd hardly be someone she likes. Mm. I don't like it anyway.
Why not?
I don't like people hitting each other. Besides, Chopped Off would end up in solitary.
Oh, well, that's the whole point. But not solitary necessarily, but Lisa would get her off the work experience program.
No.
We could help her to escape.
How would that help?
She could hardly kill Joan Ferguson while the police were out hunting for her.
Oh, they might shoot her or
but
something.
But how would they? They wouldn't know anything about it. I mean, oh. If they...
Oh, how would they know? Forget it.
You know this... You know this judo thing you do?
What about it?
Well, couldn't you break something so she'd have to stay here?
Break something?
Oh, just her little finger or something? No, 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 that's horrible. I'm sorry. Forget I said that.
Yes, I will.
Catherine Maxwell, you have been charged with the manslaughter of your daughter, Linda Jane Maxwell. How do you plead?
Guilty. But I want the court to know that the circumstances of...
The accused will have every opportunity to speak later.
No! I loved her. I loved my daughter.
And so, Your Honour, only a person who has cared for the sick can begin to understand. And even then, they can have no conception of the agony that Catherine Maxwell suffered during those four long, loving years. Years selflessly sacrificed for her little daughter. There was no respite. Medical science openly admitted they could do no more for her. There was no rest. Even in her sleep, she could hear the cries that haunted her every waking moment. Now, Your Honour, we're not saying that she didn't put an end to her child's life. What we're saying is that her actions were not premeditated. We're saying that this woman was driven beyond the bounds of human endurance and put an end to her child's suffering in a moment of total despair.
Murderer! She's a murderer!
Order! Order! I will clear the courtroom if there are any similar outbursts. This is a court of law.
Your Honour, I would ask this man be sent from the court.
I have given my ruling, Mr. Bladen.
But Your Honour...
Go on, Mr. Bladen.
Yes, Your Honour.
You are charged with entering the premises of J&R Mackenzie Milk Bar and unlawfully demanding money whilst in possession of a firearm. How do you plead?
Not guilty.
Shut up, will you?
Oh, that's right. Excuse me. Would you mind changing that to guilty? And I'll shout you a drink.
He's talking to me, you bloody idiot.
Well, how was I to know he said something?
Madam!
Yes, Your Worship?
Your Honour.
Beg yours.
You address me as... Oh, it doesn't matter. Is the accused hard of hearing?
Hey, hang on there. If you're talking about me, I'll tell you. I can hear a tinny fizz 100 yards away.
A tinny fizz?
Yeah.
What's the woman talking about?
I think she's saying that her hearing isn't impaired, Your Honour.
Her hearing? What's that got to do with the case?
You asked me if she was hard of hearing.
Excuse me, Your Worship.
Your Honour.
Oh, thanks, but just call me Ida. Is there any chance of a cuppa? My mouth feels like the bottom of a cocky's cage.
Madam, I wonder if we could confine discussion to the case at hand. You may have a tinny fizz or a cuppa during the adjournment. God knows we shall all need something by then.
How good are you? Don't eat chalk. Nice.
What in me? What in blooming thing?
He's a moon.
Go away.
Oh, come on, mate. I tell you what, I'll help you clean up. Do you want a lawn?
Why?
I just thought you might like one, that's all.
Why do you want me to help me?
Because we're mates, and mates always...
That's me, mate. She's the only friend I ever had.
Yeah, but she's gone. Now I'm your mate, remember? Well, before she left,
Yeah, I know all of that. But how do I know you're not lying? You're not going to try and get me to bash someone or something.
Bash someone? Why would I do that? I mean, Connors is the only one that said anything rotten about you. And I told her to shut up, so who would I want back?
Rena was nice to me. She's...
Yeah, that's while you were there. But when you left, she started making jokes about you and Jellyman.
She liked him. I heard her say it.
Oh, yeah. Geez, it's rotten when people talk about you behind your back, isn't it? I tell you what, I'll leave some lollies in your dorm, okay?
She liked him. She thought he was terrific.
Oh, thank heavens. I've been looking everywhere for you.
Betsy, what is the matter? Something terrible's happened, hasn't it?
Oh, no, not at all. I've worked out how to stop her.
Betsy, you just scared me half to death.
Now, are you doing a kitchen pickup?
You're talking about Rita, right?
Yes, are you doing a kitchen pickup?
You don't have to yell at me!
What? Oh, I'm sorry. Yes, you're right. Relax, relax, relax.
Now this. Whatever it is you're talking about, we'll stop Rita doing the work program, right?
No doubt at all about it. In fact, with a bit of luck, she might end up in solitary.
Nancy.
Well, there's no guarantee Miss Ferguson won't be sent out there as well, and it's too big a risk.
Well, so she ends up in solitary. What's the kitchen got to do with it?
In a nutshell, we steal some food or something, and we hide it in Rita's cell.
And?
Well, don't you see, she was working in the kitchen this morning. They'll think she stole whatever it is we hide in her cell.
Oh, but that'll mean one of us have to lag.
Oh, no, it doesn't. Oh, well, just leave all that to me. What do you think?
At least I won't have to break a little finger.
Now, Mrs. Maxwell, in your own words, just as you told me.
Linda, my daughter, suffered more in 4 years than any of us will suffer in a lifetime. Two lifetimes. I know because I suffered every minute with her. She was a good child. She